Good day, mortals. It's Pixie here. Today we're playing Hellblade. Sayuna's Sacrifice. I think I said that name correctly. I'm not sure. So this game came out a couple of days ago, and it looked very interesting. I was very intrigued by the description. A broken Celtics warrior... A broken Celtics warrior journey into the underworld to save the soul of her lover? It was something along those lines. I can't remember exactly what it was. But I am very excited for this. So, without further ado, let's get started.
Hello. Who are you?
My name's Pixie. What's yours?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, okay.
Welcome. You're safe with me.
That's
I'll good. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others.
Okay.
Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
Okay.
Deep into darkness. There will be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
They're watching.
Why isn't she coming? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I can feel you coming.
Shh. Coming.
Quiet.
Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. That's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, and they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Look. Can you see them? Over there.
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
He's in hell.
Look. Up ahead.
Alive.
You see it too?
You promised you gave
me. Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Turn back. Go back. It's not safe.
Look around and you'll see them. The drowned, the sick, the slain. Here they lie, rotting in the fields and rivers of hell. But the dead don't always lie still here.
Can you see them? Can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
They're watching.
Stop.
Can you feel them watching? They're watching her.
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness... it just builds onto itself. growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it, turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power.
They can feel you.
You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own. It isn't bravery that drives her. Bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Senua's fear runs far, far deeper. What is she looking at? What is she leaving behind? I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts. It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. Oh, she heard us. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Okay, so the opening cinematic was very scary. Can I draw a sword somehow? I'm quite scared. I'd like to get my weapon out.
You have to take a closer look to see.
Why isn't she focusing?
She needs to focus now.
She needs to use her eyes.
Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate. But gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river and will find a great
knives across which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim.
Where are you?
There's no doubt about it. The source of the darkness is in Helheim. And the goddess Hela holds his soul there. Her dear beloved, Dillian.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
Why doesn't she turn back?
She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
He's dead.
His soul is in Helheim.
His soul.
The bridge to Helheim. She forgets too. But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path into it. Let's see, shall we?
So far, I'm very much enjoying the game, but one small thing. Camera is quite hard to turn. Aside from that though, I'm liking everything.
Speak of nine worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim, and that is where you must travel.
Okay, so the key to climb lattice is F.
That's it. The way.
Don't kill me. I'm not one of them.
Don't listen.
I was just hiding. I find I live longer that way.
Don't listen.
I'll never let the bastards catch me again. Never! Wait. Who are you?
It's just a memory.
Truth? Is that you?
My tales of the Northmen. They call me Druth. A liar.
He's lost.
An old fool.
He's not there.
Druth is my truth.
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next. I will tell you my stories of hell. If I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. find one like it to open the gate.
Use your eyes. She needs to look closer.
Okay. Go back and try to find the matching.
It's near. Focus, and you will find it.
It's just like you'll never find it.
Okay, so it's disappeared now, so it's back this way. Oh, found it.
Where is the secret?
Look towards the gate, and the gate will open.
The gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
It worked.
Thank you.
Spent 6 years enslaved in hell. When I watched the Northmen, learnt their ways.
I know you did.
You listen? When everyone else laughed, my people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Hello? So is this a restart or? The voices aren't the same. Oh, I see. So you need to use A and D to balance while moving across.
The world of the dead is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the nine worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed. And with her, you must bargain.
Herself, the half-rotten goddess that rules over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him. Shh. Someone's here.
Thank you.
I'll give you what you want. I won't resist anymore. Just give him back.
Okay, so it seems that the audio. Oh! That's pretty awesome! So the combat is fairly intuitive. I really like that. Oh. So now there are multiple of them. So, alright, now I don't know what to do.
Defend yourself.
It is rot, and now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seat of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. A matter of time.
The dark rot will grow each time you fail. If the rot reaches Suena's head, her quest is over. And all progress will be lost. Okay.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. She will fulfill her vow, whatever the cost.
me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
Okay, so let's start with illusion.
Why can't she? She needs to challenge the god.
She has to fight two gods first.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
So one thing I'm going to say I really like about the game so far is the fact that I'm getting quite a lot of, I think, history. I'm assuming that what they're telling me is correct. I just did a quick internet search regarding Hela, I think that was her name, the Guardian of Hell, and so far, it did indicate that Hela was the daughter of Loki and a giantess whose name I cannot remember at this moment. I'm quite bad at remembering things.
Delusion.
I do like games that
the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
Okay. I do like games that teach history like this.
What's that? It's a door. Push it.
Just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there.
Right, so where do I go from here? Do I go down? No option to go down. Oh, perhaps the ladder will help. Completely missed that. This game is doing a very good job of making me feel on edge.
Thank you.
I've got you. How the health system is working. Do I regenerate, or is it finite per battle or per enemy? Then I recover after the battle. Do something when I see that light? Alright, so I think the battle's over. I hope.
The Northmen will not stop her. She will find what she's doing.
Gate. I have to find that symbol, which I already saw. It's up above me.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens. Allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth. Look how much it's changed.
Do I have to go? Yes, I have to climb up there to do this. Okay, I just need to figure out how to get on the wall first. If I go... Oh. That wasn't there before, was it? I don't think it was. Here we are.
Something's shifted. Something's happened. Something's shifted. Can you feel it?
So, back down. Job done. This arch. Nope, not that arch. This arch. Quite clearly this arch. I think. Maybe I have to activate the door first.
Another gate.
Another gate. You know what to do. Stay back. You have to open it. It's not.
Break the seal. Align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
Which ravens? Can't you see them? Look around. Try to find.
Line up the ravens.
Shh. What is it?
I hear something.
If you hear the soul unravel, follow it, and it will lead you to him. But be aware of his illusions. You can't always trust your mind.
Silence me!
Again, I would like to complain that the turning is very slow. And you're about to come to life, aren't you?
Who make it back are forever changed.
So if I lift this. Go back to the gate. There's one path. This way is open, but the bridge is destroyed. This way, the bridge will be intact. There's no way there, but I can just go through the gate here. I'm starting to get the hang of this. Slowly but surely. I've gone off that ladder. I don't think I have.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, while others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father.
The worst kind comes without warning. Deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Truth says there's always another route. Find a way. Go round. Find your own path. There's a different way.
There's that little light I was talking about.
Finish this! End it now!
Whoa. Two of them now. I have to be very careful. Come on. Back it, back it, back. Okay. Okay. No! Move. Okay. So far, I haven't lost a battle, with the exception of the one I was supposed to lose, so I'm feeling pretty good.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything, turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place. She thought she could beat her own.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But she it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
So this gets rid of some.
The ravens.
The ravens.
They've gone.
They're gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where?
Some are still there.
No. Oh, ravens.
Helping? He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. Where? Can't think.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on. To kill that which had become part of her.
bar this one here. Understand. Okay, so we step through again. Now the wall's repaired and we have already opened the door. So we have to go back up, around, and cross unhindered. Before we go though, what's this?
Say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
So if y'all notice, when we collected this rune, that one there was filled in. However, if you look back a little bit, this one has not filled in, so we must have missed that one at some point. So I'll do my best not to miss any more. I think this is some very important story that we need to hear.
The rings. They've gone. No.
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow, the smallest hints of shape, sound, thought, grow in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws.
Gotcha.
Hellraven. Broken. The gate is open.
Open.
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet. It will gnaw at her. Biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike. Will she find Dillion before her time comes?
Thank you. This looks a lot like an arena. Just gonna throw that out there. In case anyone's wondering what I think.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keeping. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
So I think I hop this plank, then up the ladder. Here we go. Okay, this is it.
Speak to me, Druth. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped, with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss, and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth. The man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
So I think we have to go through here again. So there's no plank, but we should be able to cross the aid of the bridge and make our way up from there. Little adjustments. There.
Focus. Valravens. Broken. The gate is open.
It's open.
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
I'm still here.
I remember. It didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in,
it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back.
But there, in the darkness,
Senua,
and she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua.
Help me.
Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus. Focus. Focus.
I see you. I see you now. You led me to the wilds. You trapped me there.
Okay. Whoop. 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 Jump, jump. And attack. Nope. Dodge. 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 And attack. Dodge. Sidestep. Oh. Oh. Our mirror on our hip looks different. It has one of the things filled in. No!
Get up quickly! Get up! Perfect, capable warrior!
Alright, take two. Where'd he go? Hello? Okay, so now he's making a attack with minions. Alright. Got a classic boss battle tactic.
He's gone.
Can I open the door? No. Can't open the door.
Don't let them surround you.
Oh no, I'm down.
Get up quick.
What the? What happened? That was odd. Come on.
It's nearly over. Finish it.
Come on. All right, back to you. Oh! Gotcha! And dodge. And attack. Go! Dodge. Okay.
Go.
Okay. Come on. I've got this. What did I do? Did I hit E? I think I might hit E. E. Yep, E works. Go. Come on. Oh, there's three of them now. Come on.
Quickly get up, they're coming.
Come on, can I hit E? There we go, E.
Take him down!
Take him down now!
Defend yourself!
Whoa! Come on! Last one!
Focus!
Get him!
The mirror
focus is building.
Oh. I can't hit you in this form.
Oh. Come this far, she needs to keep going.
Do I have to, is it on like a timer?
She needs to focus it back.
No. Come on.
Focus.
No, attack is doing nothing. Now. Come on. Whoa. Let's go. Last time, I think. No!
Quickly get up!
No! Take three. No!
Get up!
Move!
Die.
Take four. Take six. Damn it! Take... was it seven? Oh god, it takes seven.
The mill focus is coming back.
Did I get it?
I never beat you in the wilds, did I? It was an illusion. But not this time!
The mark of Valravn, one of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming.
So we're going to call it there for today, mortals. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I'm going to say, first impressions of the game, very positive. I am very happy with the game so far. It is really, really good at the atmospheric tension. Like, I feel tense while playing the game.
When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And there she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. The trees. The mountains. Caves.
So, until next time, mortals, I hope you all enjoyed. And good night.
I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother. Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the world. Like she's